Yeah.
Constantly depressed robot.
The paranoid android, yeah.
Oh, God. Poor Marvin.
So we're still waiting on food. So I think we need to just keep going.
Let's do this.
Oh God, here he comes. No, don't talk to me.
So yeah, I know there was someone that didn't eat shrimp. This one has shrimp in it. These two are vegetarian.
Phaser's exit to the bathroom.
I thought you said the fortune teller said you were like a princess from Saturn.
And tell me what you're excited about.
Having everything finished. I'm looking forward to Monday.
Worst case scenario, it fuels like other creative endeavors. Like this is just like a fun thing to like keep me going. Like, yeah, this is what it's like to get something made.
And I'm just really looking forward to the overall experience, working with people who have similar mindsets and want to do something that's different and creative within a short time frame.
I'm really excited to be part of this team. I'm looking forward to a long and full weekend of getting to know my teammates and coming up with a great story together.
So I am excited. I love this kind of stuff where you just like get away, get minds together, and make something.
Consistently and persistently undermining Christopher O'Keefe.
Hey, welcome to the Jupiter Saloon. Here's a drinks list. Here's our coolants list for the androids. Popcorn's in the machine. Karaoke starts at 9.
Wait, that's it. I know your face. You're face queen.
What we've done here and what the original experiment was, let's compress a full production timeline into a long weekend and take all those hours, all those people hours, and use them all at once and use them efficiently and use them smart and smartly.
Six Jeffs is in, right?
Yes. Please. I love Six Jeffs. And therefore, Jeff Six.
And Jeff Six.
A bit more in the second part than again, now I do. I mean, you did that, but just emphasize a bit on the like, well, now I do.
The thing that's a highlight in my life is bringing creative people together and facilitating great experiences.
But I'm ready to sit down, hammer it all out, and see what the story's actually gonna become.
Okay, so we have about 40 minutes left. We've got a rough of the first episode.
Courtney, how did you hear about this place?
Clank. Smash.
Hey, Rover! Clean up my table 15!
Things like audio fiction are not my wheelhouse. It's like actually my very first time engaging in this type of thing, so it's been very cool.
Man coming through. Heavy stuff.
That's space bass.
Base.
Yesterday when everybody came over before we were recording and we were kind of hammering out the final details of the script, it was getting a little, you could tell it was a little tense. And I was a little bit concerned with how it was gonna go. And then once we started actually recording and we're done with all the table reads, things just started to flow.
I swear it, the crows of justice will come home to roost and they will be hungry.
Enough! My God, if I had a credit for every time I heard the crows of justice speech.
Delaware, wait, please. What about the good times you've
had? Oddly enough, I can't remember any.
Flynn, trying again. So, what brings you to the Jupiter Saloon?
It's supposed to be super smart, and we didn't have time to make it super smart.
For another day, Zuz is like off Zuz hits.
What mic is Tanya on?
I went along with it, and it landed me the lead role somehow.
Podcation is coming to a close. The lasting impression I'll take from this was that such a thing is possible.
We've just finished editing the rough cut.
Lugnar?
So I think really that's what it comes down to. If you isolate people and don't give them anything to do, they'll probably make up something that's pretty good.
It's halfway made. We did it. Yeah. I'm so tired, right?
Smart, Jesse.